So this is our waiting area. Right here is where our program assistant, she checks and verifies the income. When the clients come in, they initially check in here, and then she'll call them up as they check in to verify their income.
I got to hear people come to me before I got elected and then afterwards about, we need access to service. And it was a key component, because as a teacher, I understand when we have children, we need strong, healthy children that are ready to learn. And we need, and we all get together behind families and children, and that's something that we can all appreciate, love, and support.
We need to keep growing in accessibility. We tend to build our cities around cars and not people. So this is an example of building and creating services around people.
We have several conference spaces. This one right here will be for our breastfeeding classes. This room is for our community education nurse from Penrose St. Francis, and we are excited to have them here twice a week. And so our clinic currently has 8 spaces. We only have 4 educators at the moment. We have our dietitian's office where we send our clients for high-risk counseling. This is where we perform our hemoglobin screenings as well as heights and weights in our infants. So in the center here is where we have our empty cubicles for our upcoming educators that should be here very shortly, because I see the potential growth in the clinic.
I have a husband, a former husband, who was a CPA JD. I was not working at the time because it just didn't make sense for us to have daycare for 3 kids and me be out working, and I wanted to be at home with my kids. And so for a short period of time, for 6 months, my family, I went on WIC. And because you know what, that's what social programs are for. Social programs are those gap measures where you can go on them when it's necessary, you need them. And then after 6 or 7 months, we got off of it because you know what, we got a job, we got stable again, and we were able to do that.
Currently, overall in the county, we have just under 14,000 clients. That's a lot of folks. Here in this clinic, we currently have 4 educators, WIC educators, who have a caseload of about 500 apiece, and that's only going to grow. So our hope is that in time, once we get situated down this building, that we will actually expand to additional educators coming down here to this clinic.
It's partnerships like this that we're able to connect with El Paso County and many other partners throughout our community that really allow us to be able to make the accomplishments that we're able to make.
This is where we keep all of our education materials that we need for our clients, from our breastfeeding pamphlets, from infant feeding pamphlets, to information on having a healthy pregnancy. We have our employee break room, and then as well as our pump room, where we do have really good hospital grade pumps for women who do have babies, Symphonies and Lactinas. They are rented out or loaned out on a monthly basis, and we do monthly monitoring and checking in on them just to see how breastfeeding is coming along. After a certain point with breastfeeding, and they are exclusive, we do have other pumps that we do issue out that are really good quality.
I was given support from my WIC team from day one. I was given vital information and tools to help me to provide the best insurance I could for my son at that time. I believe the staff went over and beyond for me and Josiah. And just in a short time, we were full on breastfeeding. No more supplement with formula. That was a very proud day for me.
Most people don't know this about me, but as a young girl growing up in La Junta, my family received WIC benefits for a time. So this opening brings me personal joy, because I know there are other families like mine. Families who do the very best they can, but sometimes it just isn't enough.